In December 2019, China notified the World Health Organization of several cases of human respiratory illness.
And scientists say a new virus related to SARS may be responsible for a mysterious pneumonia outbreak in China. The new coronavirus was found in 15 of 59 patients with the illness. The virus is spread through coughing or sneezing or by touching an infected person.
I'm Dr. Chandrani Singh, Director, Siogal Institute of Management, MCA Department, Pune, India. I and my colleagues have created a very wonderful video on COVID-19 pandemic, which has currently ravaged the world. I would appreciate if you can take a few minutes out of your time and listen to this wonderful video. As a leader of that institution, I would also like to say a few words. The coronavirus outbreak has been the biggest crisis the world has ever faced so far, with most parts of the globe under the lockdown to stop the spread of virus. While the experts and the healthcare team attend to patients round the clock, the world is in a state of uncertainty, but not everyone feels they are helpless. The bright mind handles uncertainties effectively. They gather whatever facts they can and take the best shot to progress ahead. As in any case, leadership evolves. People rise to occasions and face challenges. They spring into actions and motivate others around them. All things must pass and eventually should pass. In a crisis filled with unknowns and surprises, one can't wait for all the facts to become clear before deciding what to do, says Gemma Diora and Aaron D. Smith, senior partners, McKinsey Company. I was reading through the McKinsey report on the current crisis, and I would like to list out practices from the report that can help lead your organization through this unsettled times. Build a network of teams, as in any case, crisis situation, you need to have network of teams, and these are the crisis times which require a lot of commitment from the teams. Many times survival itself could be at stake. Clear and open communication. Understand the facts and communicate clearly. This will help the team communicate effectively. And lastly, I would like to emphasize on 2 points. Document the learning responses and back to numerous situations. The corona outbreak followed by the nationwide lockdown, in fact a global lockdown, has given each one of us many learnings. We should list our learnings, the responses and the impact on each situation, and be prepared to face the challenges head on. While many would heave a sigh of relief and return to normal routines when the crisis subsides, it is important to keep in mind the learning during the crisis so that we could evolve better and stronger before, and we should be prepared for a changed world post-COVID. Do not be surprised to observe a changed world. The world that emerged will not be the same as before. The economic crisis, the job losses, the loss of dear ones, the travel restrictions, social distancing, everything will have an impact, and this will be felt across the world by one and all. As educationists, online education, communication skills, skill development, more degrees than degrees and certificates will decide the job opportunities for the youth, and we need to strengthen ourselves and prepare for whatever comes next. The time has come for all to rise to the future with an innovative mindset. Thank you. Thank you all.
Hello, I'm Dr. Manisha Kumar, Professor and Academic Coordinator, Srinagar Institute of Management.
In light of the COVID-19 situation, we, faculty of Sinhagad Institute of Management, enlighten few aspects of COVID-19 with selected countries all over the world. We are coming together to work in a new ways to identify challenges and solutions together. Government of India is taking all necessary steps to ensure that we are prepared well to face the challenges and threat posed by the growing pandemic of COVID-19. The coronavirus. The COVID-19 that has been spreading worldwide since December 2019 has sickened millions of people, shut down major cities, prompted unprecedented global travel restrictions, and influenced the global spread of misinformation and panic. This COVID-19 became global pandemic, and panic is spreading among every single generation of population. The first COVID-19 case in India was reported on January 30, 2020 in a Kerala's Thrissur district, and the patient is a student studying in Wuhan, China. The total number of coronavirus cases in India has reached 26,917 as of April 26, 2020 till 5 p.m., including 20,177 active cases, 826 deaths, and 5,913 discharged patients along with one migrated patient, as per the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, India. India has started Mission Lifeline Udaan, in which flights were operated to transport essential medical cargo to remote parts of the country to support India's war against COVID-19. And till date, 684 tons of essentials and medical supplies reach across India to fight COVID-19 pandemic. Mission Lifeline Udaan is in a full swing. No Indian will be left behind. Together we shall overcome this pandemic situation. Each of us are doing a great work, but we cannot work alone. We are all in this together, and we will only get through it together. India can, India will.
Hello friends, I am Dr. Milind Godse. As we know, the COVID-19 cases in South Africa have been increasing gradually. So I want to give you some tips to prevent COVID-19 infections. Number one, wash your hands often with soap and water for at least 20 seconds. If soap and water are not available, use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer. Second, avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth with unwashed hands. Third, avoid close contact with people who are sick. Fourth, stay at home when you are sick and try and keep a distance from others at home. Fifth, cover your cough or sneeze with a flexed elbow or a tissue, and then throw the tissue in the bin. Sixth, clean and disinfect frequently touched objects and surfaces. Friends, my message to you all is to save South Africa. Please, please stay at home. Thanks.
The United Arab Emirates country also facing a problem of coronavirus, so that the government has launched a various incentives to the country, including banking facility to various economic sector and small medium enterprises, in addition to individual as well as granting exemption, postponing due and opening other related facility. It also provides the financial incentives in coordination with the local banks and in cooperation with Department of Finance and Economic Development, with immediate support to reducing financial cost. In addition to reduction of municipality fees on sales at hotels from 7% to 3.5%, an economic relief package amounting to more than $1 billion to implemented on case-by-case basis, no annual registration fees for commercial vehicles, payment of approved government invoices within 15 working days, subsidies for electric connection fees for startup for this year, and up to 20% rebate on rental for the restaurant, tourism and entertainment sector. Thank you.
Every day COVID-19 seems to reach at new level. More than 2,948 positive cases reported in Bangladesh, and more than 100 people have lost their lives. Of course, Bangladesh must exercise caution. My research study is limited to current situation of education sector in Bangladesh. Major highlights are remote and online education launch on public Bangladesh television. Teaching learning started through government agency. About 65% of universities have started holding online classes to keep academic door of knowledge open. College teachers are constantly communicating with all students and ensuring their well-being and study. UNICEF and World Health Organization is working with Bangladesh government to implement effective remote teaching. ICT division of Bangladesh government will trying to make online teaching interactive and engaging students, teachers and ensuring assessment of teaching. Bangladesh researchers are developing COVID-19 epidemic model to observe and estimate the pattern of disease to reduce continuous infection and to analyze the rate of outbreak of virus. Radiation Technologies Limited developed a Bluetooth-based software app to check symptoms of coronavirus disease by uploading chest X-ray. COVID-19 is taking so much from Bangladesh people, but it also giving opportunity to learn online together, grow together, and increase your knowledge on healthy behavior.
Hi, Ramesh D. Jadhav. Let us look novel coronavirus impact on Saudi Arabia country. It is a country in Western Asia and it have a population 34 million. On 2nd March, Saudi Arabia Ministry of Health confirmed the first case of the COVID-19 disease. As of April 25th, the kingdom had 16,299 confirmed cases out of 2,215 recoveries and 136 deaths. The death ratio of the kingdom is 0.84% and up to 2 lakh tests are completed. And the ministry has designed 25 hospitals for coronavirus treatment with capacity of 80,000 hospital beds and 8,000 ICU, and more 2,000 beds have been allocated for quarantine facility. And the hospital uses robot ready to treat COVID-19 facility. This is the fact of in Saudi Arabia country. Thank you.
New Zealand is a sovereign island country in the southwestern Pacific Ocean. The total population of New Zealand is 4.8 million. As per the statistics on 25th April 2020, total cases were reported are 1142 and recovered were 1121. To fight with coronavirus, New Zealand has introduced a fall level alert model, which is proving a model of recovery. New Zealand was closed down to all non-residents from 19th March 2020. The New Zealand borders were controlled with high-quality quarantine of incoming travelers. Intensive hygiene promotion was done throughout the country. The Prime Minister regularly appears Facebook live chats. They also have a social media connect, Unite Against COVID-19, with Twitter and Facebook. Thank you.
Population of Singapore is around 58,50,000, and as on 24th April, the COVID confirmed cases were 12,693, of which 956 recovered, 11,725 were active, and 12 deaths. The death ratio in percentage is 0.099. The first case of COVID-19 in Singapore was confirmed on 23rd January. The Ministry of Education has declared to bring forward the mid-year holidays to coincide with extension period and have made changes in the academic calendar and started full home-based learning using video conferencing platforms. In response to growing number of new cases, on 3rd April, Singapore announced a stringent set of preventive measures, which were collectively called as circuit breaker, to be applied from 7th April to 4th May, with an extension to 1st June announced on 21st April.
Japan, the country of courageous people who have faced natural and man-made disasters in history, are once again in trouble and are struggling with COVID-19 along with the rest of the world. Japan's coronavirus patients are on the rise even as the government continues to implement safety measures. Japan currently experiences cold climate with temperatures falling below 0 degrees Celsius, making infection control difficult. The government declared a state of emergency for Tokyo, Osaka and 5 other prefectures on 7th April, but it expanded and declared nationwide. Medical experts say infections are not slowing as they expected. Tokyo's slogan against corona says, "Stay home week to save lives," and the period to stay home may extend further even after 6th May. As per a recent survey, one in every 13 university students in Japan is considering leaving school as the coronavirus outbreak has left many of them without a source of income or financial support. Just like other nations, Japan itself is trying to find a cure to this virus and is in a period of uncertainty.
Hi, this is Professor Sheila Hundekari talking about COVID-19 effect on Israel country. The total population of Israel is 86,55,535 as per 2020. The effect on this of COVID-19 is total cases of this disease is 15,148, deaths 198, active cases 8,791 and recovered cases are 6,519. So Israel's best part is COVID-19 treatment with 100% survival rate tested on US patient. The critical part is damage to Israel's economy estimated to $12 billion. The apps that are being there to trace this COVID-19 is Trace Together.
I, Manoj Samanan, present the statistic of Canada country regarding COVID-19. The first COVID-19 case is found in 25th January, which is traveler from China. After that, the Canada government has started the scanning facility in their airport. Till date, 13,995 cases are found. In that, 245 patients are in critical condition, 811 are dead, and till date 217,680 tests are completed. Also, government has declared $82 billion package to boost the economy. Also, government has published online app.
Malaysia, which is also facing problem of coronavirus with population of approx more than 3 crore, the first case was registered on 25th Jan. Till 25th April, there are 5,742 cases with 3,542 cases recovered and death it is 98 with ratio of 1.7%. Graph shows that females are 25% and male it is 75% males are there. Age group it is belong from 50 to 80 age. The accelerated testing revealed that the country is doing well, maintaining the fatality rate of 1.7%, and the target of government is to keep it under 1. MOC, which is a lockdown, Malaysia Movement Control, has started on March 18 and today it is extended till 12th May and it is doing well. And if government guidelines are followed properly, the number are expected to come down. And once the death cases are achieved, active cases are under the threshold, the country can plan to reopen. Thank you.
Brazil is the world's fifth largest country by area in both South America and Latin America. On 25th February 2020, a 61-year-old man who traveled from Italy tested positive for the virus. 59,324 cases are infected with corona. Currently, 68% are in mild conditions and 32% are in serious situations. Till now, 33,217 cases are recovered and 4,057 are the deaths. On 27 March, Brazil announced a temporary ban on foreign air travelers and most state governors have imposed quarantines to prevent the spread of the virus. The National School of Public Administration has developed the Challenges platform. The system invites society to participate in the construction of groundbreaking solutions to help the country face COVID-19 pandemic. The federal government created All for All campaign where business entities and associations, in addition to public agencies, can offer products and services free of charge due to emergency basis. Brazilian transparency portal discloses specific federal spending related to combating the COVID-19. Governors infected are quarantined.
COVID-19 is well controlled in Russia. Most important part is the death ratio as compared to the other countries. The ratio is below 1% all the times. Russia has a total number of ventilators around 42,000 to 43,000. It's an average about 29 ventilators 4 lakh residents. The Russian government has already instructed to get more ventilators. Also, important part, they are increasing the number of tests per day. They have more than 370 plus special COVID-19 test labs to conduct these such cases. Russian government has already announced various relief packages to various sectors, including small scale and medium scale enterprises.
Hi, this is Dushan Burke, giving the current scenario of Sweden on COVID-19. There are around 2,000 plus deaths happening in Sweden, and still the corona cases are increasing day by day. Total corona positive cases 16,700 and only 550 cases recorded. This report is up to 25th April 2020. Good news is that there are some COVID-19 cases which are recorded, but their percentage is very low when we comparing from daily new cases. Statistical analysis of Sweden COVID cases, date-wise, age-wise, gender-wise, region-wise, shown in the PPT. The Swedish government on Monday presented a package of measure worth more than 300 billion Swedish crowns to support the economy in the face of the coronavirus pandemic. Microsoft and Swedish government joined forces over the past 2 weeks to build an app that helps hospital staff monitor resources for COVID-19 related care. The COVID-19 emergency response app was released on April 1st, and since with hospital dashboard to help Swedish leaders. So this is the highlight at COVID-19 in Spain.
Hello friends, this is Sachin Sabnis. Let us look at the COVID-19 epidemic in Australia. The population of Australia is nearly 25.67 million. On 25th of Jan, the first case of corona infection was reported in the country. As on 26th of April, 6,711 confirmed cases have been reported, out of which 5,539 have been recovered, while 89 deaths have been confirmed. Australia has conducted 5,06,449 corona tests. The percentage of positive cases is 1.32% and the death ratio is 1.23%. A social distancing rule was imposed by the government on 29th of March. The country has observed the decline in new positive cases since 30th of March. This is all the facts about Australia. Thank you.
Hi, myself, I am Professor Balchandra Doddi. Let's we see some details about Netherlands COVID-19 up to date 26th April of this year. By now, many laboratories in the Netherlands was tested to check whether people are infected with the coronavirus. Details are as follows. 37,190 are the total cases, out of which 2,500 are active cases, 934 are serious critical cases. The number of people death due to coronavirus was 4,400, and an average of daily new cases was found up to 550. This slide also contains some graphical representation of day wise total coronavirus cases and daily new cases. Due to COVID-19 infect, the people are becoming panic for buying of food, medicines, grocery items, which affect on Dutch economy that is expected to shrink by 1.2% in 2020. If these measures are required for a year, the economy would decline by 10%. Let's see some highlights. Prime Minister Mark Rutte made following announcement to avoid spread of coronavirus. On 12 March, it was announced that all public events with more than 100 people will be cancelled until 6 April. On 24 March, this period was extended to 1st June for all permit requiring events. 3 days later, it was announced in a press conference that all restaurants, museums, sports clubs and schools had to close. Keep distance, work from home as much as possible, and groups are prohibited. No public transports are available. Following are the most important measures to prevent from coronavirus. Stay at home as much as possible. Stay 1.5 meters away from other people. Do not shake hands. Wash your hands with soap and water. Cough and sneeze into your elbow. This slide also contains some details about government sites, helpline numbers and COVID-19 app details.
Hello, I'm Professor Rahul Mole. I'm taking United Kingdom country for the research of COVID-19. As on date, number of confirmed cases in UK is the 143,466 and number of deaths is the 19,506. So death ratio is the overall death rate from the COVID-19 has been estimated at 0.66%, rising sharply to the 7.8% in our people. So when we are talking about the awareness about COVID, WHO and FIFA launched a joint campaign to equip the football community to tackle COVID-19. So precaution is that in February 2020, it was found that 62% British people surveyed in the United Kingdom were consciously washing their hands with soap and water as a precaution against COVID-19, while 49% people respondent were using hand sanitizer to protect against the virus. After that, government has started some initiatives. So coronavirus job retention scheme is there, deferring VAT and income taxes, tax payments is there, and statutory seat pay relief package for small size businesses. That is my findings in the research. Thank you.
I'm Professor Rahul Borate. I'm working on the country France for the COVID-19 research, and still now I'm getting some finding that is number of confirmed cases is 1.50 lakh and number of deaths in France is 22,000 and the number of recovered cases are 42,000. Again, death ratio of France is almost 2.8%, and the number of cases date wise increasing from 3rd of March to the up to the 25th of April in an increasing order, in an exponential order. Again, the number of hospitalized cases date wise is up to the 14th of April it is increased, and after that the graph is again goes on decreasing. Again, France is using the nicotine tablets for the treatment against the COVID-19. This is my finding about the COVID-19 in France. Thank you.
Germany is a country in Central and Western Europe. Germany has a population of over 83 million people. Germany's total count of coronavirus cases has reached 1.5 lakh. At least 40,000 patients are active cases and 95,000 people have been cured. The coronavirus death toll stands at 5,500 so far. The COVID-19 pandemic was confirmed to have reached Germany on 27th January 2020. Germany has among the highest number of coronavirus cases in Europe, but it has avoided the high death rate seen elsewhere on the continent. Analysis into why Germany's death rate is so low usually point to the country's rigorous testing system. The country developed a test for the coronavirus back in January weeks before it records its first case. Germany now carries out about 500,000 tests each week across a vast network of laboratories. German authorities to detect mild and asymptomatic cases which might go underdetected in other countries that don't have the same testing capabilities. Germany's capacity to deal with the crisis can understand when looking at the number of hospital beds. Germany has 6 acute care beds for every 100 patients. The German government also aimed to increase its stock of ventilators to 35,000. Germany banned gathering of more than 2 people and respective measures with effect from March 22.
Can be difficult time for all of us as we hear about spread of COVID-19 from all sources. I'm here to explain the statistic of COVID-19 in a China country. The origin of coronavirus started in Wuhan, Hubei of China. Wuhan is the city of more than 11 million people, and it is the 7th largest city in China. The first patient with this coronavirus has been hospitalized in December 16, 2019. Till date in China, 84,302 total cases mentioned. Out of that, 77,257 patients are recovered and total 4,642 patients are dead. Statistically, analysis of state-wise COVID-19 cases are shown in a bar chart, and age-wise, age group-wise total number of dead till date is shown in a pie chart. China deployed Thor 1 robot to fight the deadly coronavirus. Also, it can take the help of other robots also to support nurses in a hospital to delivering medicine and or talking to the patient.
Hi friend, as we know that today the whole world is suffering due to the global pandemic COVID-19. Till date, the more than 2 lakhs deaths are due to only the COVID-19 globally. I am here to explain the status of COVID-19 in Spain country. Till date, in Spain, the mentioned positive cases are 2,13,024. Total death 22,156. Recovered cases are 89,250. The statistical analysis of state-wise COVID-19 cases, death and recovery cases are shown in bar chart. And the age group wise total number of death till date is shown in pie chart. The country has developed Assistencia COVID-19 app for detecting the active cases around us. Hence, one can easily find out the positive cases around us. This is the highlight of COVID-19 in Spain. Thank you.
South Korea population 51,261,479 April 26, 2020. Based on Worldmeter elaboration of the latest United National data, South Korea population is equivalent to 0.66% of the total world populations. The first case in South Korea was identified on 20 January 2020, followed by the detection of one or two cases on average in the subsequent days. COVID-19 in South Korea and support the implementation of social distancing measures to rapidly control the outbreak. Confirmed cases of coronavirus in South Korea as on April 26, 2020 was 10,072, total deaths 242 and recovered cases 8,717.
Around 33 crores population in United States. First case of the COVID-19 was recorded on 20 January 2020 in United States. Till 24th April 2020, we found approx 9,59,258 cases of corona. Out of that, 54,157 deaths are recorded. As of now, total hospitalization cases are 97,399. If we calculate cases per capita, then it's around 290, and similarly, deaths per capita is around 16.4. United States performed more than 54,46,000 testings of corona patients till now.
Now, look at the situation in Italy with a population of 60.5 million, confirmed cases 1.9 million, death cases 26,000, recovered cases 60,000. Italy was unlucky in being hit hardest, first in Europe. Its neighbors and the US should have learned from its missteps. Italy is doubling down on its lockdown strategy to stop the spread of the new coronavirus, halting all non-essential economic activities for 2 weeks. Italy was the first European country to discover a serious domestic outbreak, which helps in part to explain why it is now widespread. In Italy, the northern region of Lombardy has been the hardest hit. Nearly half of all registered cases and 2/3 of official deaths come from this area, which accounts for 1/6 of Italy's population. More than 4,000 healthcare workers have tested positive for the virus. There is no direct vaccine available till now to get a proper cure after being infected. So viewers, it's time to think and rethink on which side you want to fall in, whether to see yourself, your nearer and dearer ones, to be a victim of this deadly virus, or stay away and be safe from it. Choice is yours.